Welcome to TradeTheNBA.com. This is John. This report is for the 1st of February, and I put in this little white line here to indicate the beginning of the year so that you can get a relative terms as to where we started and where we're at so far after 1 month. A little bit higher, but right in line with the continuation of the move up. There's no real fear going on. There's just been a slowdown because they've been waiting for positive action both on some of the Trump nominees for positions that will affect where stimulus and or additional infrastructure planning, and that's been stalled a little bit, and so that's caused a little bit of a slowdown is all it is, until there's some clarity as to the direction things will go. There's no question that eventually they're going to get through. The question really is how long it will take, and then whether or not Republicans will slow the process or get on board and move as fast as Trump has been moving so far this last 10 days. It's an amazing thing when you think about what we've seen in the past. Things have moved at what some are thinking is a little bit too quick. And so trying to dial it back a little bit. Of course, we had the Supreme Court announcement. Nothing dramatic on that. Certainly is going to be important because I think a lot of what Trump wants to do is going to require having a judicial branches in place, because obviously there's going to be a lot of contention with that. You can see that we've moved back into my zone of the euro. This is partly because we've seen significant slowing in the U.S., where everyone thought the U.S. economy was going to be ramping up. We got into the danger zone, central banks stepped in, we got back into what I saw was a minimum threshold for them, and now we're back into what should be the normal trading range, as we've talked about, well, for quite some time. Bonds see a positive reaction. Unlikely the Fed is going to do anything. That's actually a bonus for Treasury TLT here moving up, because obviously with that weakness, not likely to see a rate increase. The Fed talk about things being accelerated was probably just that, a little bit too far ahead of where things actually are. And so there's going to be a little slowdown in some of these things. And again, like I said, there's just no trade in oil at this particular point. And we've talked about how gold was the opportunity on the dip to acquire back into it, and sure enough, no surprise with that. And from an intraday standpoint, this is the adjusted shakeout that I sent, and I was talking to members about this before. When we get that reset of the orange below the red right here, probably we'll see my next adjustment where the cyan moves below red should have turned my histogram bar earlier there, and then also the potential of what normally would be, we were talking about a buy, was when the steel comes back below the 7.5 on rising shakeout there, with yellow moving would be even further back by a couple of bars, which is exactly the opportunity that I took right there. We talked about that as was happening. Yes, we've got some positive extremes, so there'll be some backfilling, but you can see stayed nicely with it, and that's an encouraging adjustment, and we're really getting tight on how some of that follows. So we had a lot of that soft weakness, and it turned around. There was a number two that came here, which was the green coming over the red, which was the beginning of it, but the reset of that orange right down here, if I put it in the signal, I don't think you can see it there at the bottom of the chart. I have to move into the shakeout. Let's slide it up a little bit, and we can kind of see a little clearer that way. So there it is at the minus 14, which is below the red minus 11, and that was the signal. And then you wait for that steel under the 7.5, which put the entry right there at the 65.75 range. So it's a couple of bars before where even the adjusted shakeout, because I have to add that additional language into it, because it's a little complicated with the determination, because I'm also factoring in when it's stuck between the cyan and red, which usually indicates a continuation zone, like we had all the way through here. Even though there was a slight pop, we didn't dip below the red, and it obviously created that next downturn when the steel dropped back below the cyan. So that's that short-term buyers versus shorts creating a little intraday, but then we get the broader oversold. And it's always nice when you dip below the negative 13.5 for the red, because then you're not in that no spark zone. And sure enough, it created a liftoff that just is continuation. And then you get the beautiful ABM, makes it really easy to stick behind that. So pre-market up a little bit, was up significantly more than that. It's got to fill back and ease off some of that, but cyan below the red, always a bullish configuration. So an nice start to the new month, and you can expect some continued adjustments. I'm going to be reflecting the pink bar to adjust to what the shakeout is doing here, so you'll be able to see the matching relationship between the two, in which case when you get to that point, you're not going to need to see as much of the other indicators. You'll be able to see it directly in the paint bar, which has ultimately been the goal to make those adjustments. So all in all, good start to things, and great positioning. As always, though, continue to look for me on the Skype chat. We'll keep putting up the latest charts, and have a good one. Trade well.